The following is a class on the Srimad Bhagavatam, 1st Canto, 8th Chapter, Text Number 34, given by His Divine Grace, A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada, recorded on April 26, 1973, in Los Angeles.
Translation. Others say that the world, being overburdened like a boat at sea, is much aggrieved, and that Brahma, who is your son, prayed for you, and so you have appeared to diminish the trouble.
So, Kunti Devi is describing different statements of different persons why Krishna appeared. Somebody says that he appeared on the request of Devaki and Vasudev. Somebody says he appeared on the request of Brahma. there is Bhubhara. Bhubhara, it is a Bharavataranaya Anni Bhuva. Nava ivo dadho. Bhubhar, this world becomes overburdened. As soon as it becomes overburdened, there must be a war, pestilence, famine, epidemic, and finish. This is natural. Overburdened. Nature's law. This is called in economic there is some law. So why the world becomes so overburdened? The earth planet, not only earth planet, there are many millions of other planets also. They are bearing big mountains, big ocean. Why it becomes overburdened? Yes. First of all, we have to consider how this planet is floating in the air. It is floating in the air, as it is stated in the Bhagavad Gita, Gama Vishya, because Krishna enters within this. Krishna, just like he enters within the atom. So, he is the spirit, supreme spirit. So, because the supreme spirit is within, therefore it is floating, not that weightlessness. Weight is there, very heavy weight. Just like you can test, this body will float in the water so long you are living. As soon as this spirit soul goes, then immediately the body goes down. The law of gravity acts, the so-called law of gravity. This is an example. A child, so long it is living, you can take in one hand. But as soon as the child is dead, it becomes heavier. That is natural. So everything is lighter. As soon as it is spiritually advanced, or there is spirit. Similarly, when we will be spiritually advanced, then there will be no impediment. Now we cannot fly in the air, but when you are free from this body, your spirit soul, within a second you can go to the Vaikuntha Loka. It is so light. within a second. Takta deham punarjanma naiti mamit. So the conclusion is, when the world becomes overloaded with the demons, non-devotees, it becomes disturbed. The Mother Earth feels load, very much load. So at that time, Krishna comes. Therefore it is said, Bhara Avataranaya, just to unload. And Bhara Avataranaya Anne, somebody says, Vo, Navo Ibodadhu. Just like if a ship or boat is overloaded, it is very dangerous. It can be drowned at any moment. So, Siddhantya Bhuribharena, so Mother Earth was overloaded and she approached Brahma on account of overloading of these demons. She was feeling too much uncomfortable, and Brahma is the chief living being within this universe. So when there is need, others approaches Brahma and Brahma approaches Vishnu to reduce the overburden, and then he takes his incarnation, and that is stated in the Bhagavad Gita. Jada jada hi dharmasya glani bhavati bharata abhutthanam adharmasya. Abhutthanam adharmasya. When the principles of religiosity becomes increased, at that time I appear, Krishna says. Let's take for example, when there are too much criminals in the state, unlawful, lawlessness, the state becomes overburdened, disturbed, overburdened. At that time, the administrators are puzzled what to do. Similarly, when the world is overburdened by atheists, demons, non-believers, the world becomes overburdened. Otherwise, things will go on nicely. Just like in the state, if people abide by the laws nicely, then it is very easy to administer. Things are going on very nicely. But if people become criminals, it becomes an overburden to the state administrators. So such thing happens. Because this is material world, and the demons and the demigods, they are always there, existing. But when the demonic power becomes increased, then the world becomes overburdened. Siddhantya Bhuribharena Jata Jata. He Atma Bhuvarthita, Atma Bhu. Atma Bhu is Brahma's name. He is directly born of the Supreme Soul, Vishnu. He is not born as usually we do from the womb of mother. So Brahma was born from the navel of Garbhodakshaya Vishnu. Therefore his another name is Atmabhu, Swayambhu, Swayambhu. These are different names of Brahma. Swayambhu, Narada, Sambhu. These are the Brahma is one of the authorities. He is also mentioned in the list of authorities, Dadas Mahajan, 12 authorities, Sambhu, Narada, Sambhu, Kapila, Mano, Prahlada, Janaka, Bhishma, Bali, Vaiyasaki, Vayam. You have to follow the Mahajan, great authorities. If we want to be in knowledge of everything, then the Vedic instruction is that tadvijnanartham sa guru meva vigacchet. One has to approach guru. So, guru means authority. So there are original guru is Krishna, as Krishna is teaching to Arjuna. Similarly, he also taught Brahma. Teni Brahma Rida Adikavai. That is the statement in the Srimad Bhagavatam. Janmadasya jataha annayat itaratascha arthesu avijna sarat. That should be the subject matter of research work. Where is the original source of creation? Janmadasya jataha. From where janma, sthiti and prala is taking place. That we have got experience. Janma, we have taken our birth at a certain date. This body is born. This sthiti, we stay. This body will run on for some years. 10 years, 20 years, 50 years, according to the body. Then it will be finished. So where from this body came, and where, after finishing, where it goes. There are so many scientific laws, conservation of energy. So, who is that conservation or the source of energy? That is stated in the Srimad Bhagavatam, Janmadasya Jataha. There is source. It is not blind, just like this rascal thing, it has come out of nothing. How something can come out of nothing? There is no proof. But they claim like that. Therefore they are blind. No. Bhagavad says, janmadasya jataha annayat itaratascha arthishu abhijna. The original source from whom everything has come and in whom everything is existing and within whom everything will enter. Jatoba imani bhutani jayanti. These are the Vedic instructions. So, what is the nature of that thing? Where from things are coming, emanating? Things are existing, and again, after being finished, it is entering. Prakritiṃ jānti māmikāṁ. In the Bhagavad Gita, Krishna says, the prakriti enters into me. So they do not know. So what is that source? Therefore Bhagavad says that supreme source is janmadasya jata annayat itaratastra arthesu abhijna. Abhijna means completely conscious. Go means knowledge. So abhijna, abhi means specifically go, not like ours knowledge. We do not know. We have no sufficient knowledge where from I have come, where I shall go after death, that we do not know. Therefore we are not abhijna. But the supreme source is abhijna. He is not a stone, void. No. How it can be? Such a nice creation, everyone can appreciate this created cosmic manifestation, how it is nicely working. The sun is rising exactly in time, without any division, even 1/10,000 part of a second. The moon is rising, the seasons are changing, in the season the fruits and flowers coming. See, in this way, the whole cosmic manifestation is going on very orderly, systematically. Everyone can understand that. So unless there is some abhijna, very clever brain who knows everything, how it is created. That they say that it has come out of nothing. What is this nonsense? Can such thing come out of nothing? Is that very good reasoning? No. Bhagavad says, no, it is coming from the person who is abhijna, very experienced. And that abhijna, tene, janmadasya jata annayat itaratascha arthesu abhijna tene. Tene means he broadcasted knowledge. To whom? Adikavai, the original creature. The Brahma is the original creature. Therefore, he has got contact with the original source. He has got this original source. How he receives knowledge? Because we have got understanding that we get knowledge from another person when we are face to face. But Brahma was alone. How he got the knowledge? That is explained in the Bhagavatam. Tene Brahma Rida. Rida means through the heart. Because the Supreme Person, Paramatma, is also within the heart. So although Brahma was alone, he was getting the knowledge, dictation, from the Supreme. Tene Brahma. Brahma means knowledge. Brahma means Ved. The Vedic knowledge was given to him first. Tene Brahma Rida. The Vedic knowledge is given to everyone because Krishna is in everyone's heart. Sarvasya chaham hridi sannivishta. He is sitting in everyone's heart. But one must be qualified to receive the knowledge. Krishna is helping us. From within, he is giving us knowledge. From within, without also. So without his spiritual master. And within, his super soul. Chaitta Guru. In this way, we are getting knowledge. So Brahma is getting knowledge from Krishna. And Brahma is distributing Vedic knowledge. Therefore, he is authority. We belong to the Brahma Sampradaya. Our, this Chaitanya Mahaprabhu Sampradaya, there are four Sampradayas. One from Brahma, one from Sri Lakshmi, one from Shambhu, Lord Shiva, and one from Kumara, Kapila, Mani. So there are four Vaishnava Sampradayas. So we have to approach the authoritative representative of Brahma, Krishna, then we can get the real knowledge. Therefore, this earth personified approach, Brahma, Bhuvarthita, jato. So Brahma afraid to the Supreme Personality of Godhead that this is the position of the world. It is now overburdened with demons. So Krishna comes, yada yada hi dharmasya glani bhavati, abhuthanam adharmasya tada atmanam sijamaham. He appears. This is the process. So somebody says Krishna appeared on the request of Brahma when he prayed for his appearance on account of overburden weight of the world. So Krishna came and you have seen our Krishna book how much he is engaged in killing the demons. So Krishna says that I come down paritrana sadhuna vinashaya to kill the demons. So killing business is there. Krishna, although he is killing and protecting the same thing because he is absolute, but the killing business is there. Therefore Krishna has, the Narayana has got two hands, club and disc. That is for killing the demons. And two hands, corn cell and lotus flower. That is for the devotees. The devotees are protected. Kauntiya pratijani hi nami bhakta pranasyati. Krishna is bugling with his counsel that my devotees will not be vanquished. And the lotus flower is the symbol of blessing. It is in the hands of Lakshmiji also sometimes blessing. So somebody says that Krishna appeared for this purpose. Somebody says Krishna appeared for his purpose. But the real conclusion is that Krishna appears for his own pleasure. For not being bound by any cause. Krishna is fully independent. Just like we take our birth being bound by the cause of our karma. Krishna does not come being bound up by somebody's request or by his karma. He comes out of his free will. Atma-maya, it is said, atma-maya. He is not compelled by any other's maya. Just like we are compelled by the energy of Krishna, external energy, this material energy. We are compelled to take birth. Krishna does not take birth in such condition. Atma-maya, not by the... because maya is under the control of Krishna. So how maya can control Krishna? One who thinks that Krishna is also like us, controlled by maya, they are called murhas. Apajananti maga mura manasintanumas. Read the purpose.
Brahma, or the first living being, born just after the creation, is the direct son of Narayana. Narayana, as Garbhodakashayi Vishnu, first of all entered the material universe. Without spiritual contact, matter cannot create.
This is the beginning of creation. Those who are finding out the original cause of material creation, they should know this fact that creation takes place when there is spirit soul. That means living. The matter is not created. Matter is created by the spirit soul. Not the soul is created by matter. This is Rascal's theory, that this living condition, living force, living energy which you have got, it is created by material condition. This is Buddhist theory. At the present moment, the whole world is going on this Buddhist theory, that under certain condition, the matter develops living force. No, that is not. Actually, the fact is, upon the living force, matter increases. That we can understand very easily. Apart from our knowledge within the womb of the mother, how the body develops, we can see if a child is born, he grows, his body develops. But if the child is born dead, no spirit soul, it will not develop. Everyone knows that. Therefore, the spirit is the basis of development of matter. Not that by development of matter, spirit grows. No, that's not fair. This is, everyone knows, why a dead child does not grow. Because the spirit is not there. A tree grows so long there is life in it. A small seed of banyan tree you sow in the soil and pour water favorably, then it grows because the spirit soul is there. But if somehow or other, take for example, you take one grain and fry it in the fire, if you sow it, it will not grow. Because the spirit soul is not there. Therefore, they are searching after what is the original cause of creation. The original cause of creation is the spirit soul. As everything is growing, matter is growing, developing, on account of the spirit soul, similarly, the whole universe is growing on account of presence of Garbhodha Sai Vishnu. Creation.
This principle was followed from the very beginning of the creation. The Supreme Spirit entered the universe, and the first living being, Brahma, was born on a lotus flower grown out of the transcendental abdomen of Vishnu.
Now, just like sometimes we see, take for example Brahma, he grew from the lotus flower. So one can say this lotus flower is matter. No, the lotus flower has grown from the navel of Vishnu. The original cause is Vishnu. If you take the lotus flower as matter, then it has also grown from the spirit. This is the beginning. The spirit soul is the basis of creation. What is the difficulty to understand? We can see practically. Unless there is spirit soul, there cannot be. Just like this body, your body, my body, even elephant's body, it has grown. It has grown because the spirit soul is there. As soon as the spirit soul is not there, there will be no more growth. No more growth, and the body will be heavy. Due to the spirit soul within the body is light. You can make an experiment. You just have a weight of a dead body and of a living body, you will find difference. What is the difference? What is our scientist? Now, you find it the difference that the dead body is more weight?
Yes.
Why? because the spirit soul is not there. These are experimented even by the scientists. So this world is floating in the air because the spirit soul is within it. Therefore it is floating. That is explained in the Bhagavad Gita. Gama Vishya. I enter and dharayami aham ojasa. So as soon as the spirit soul will be off, everything will be destroyed. The destruction of this cosmic manifestation is like that.
Vishnu is therefore known as Padmanabha. Brahma is known as Atmapu because he was begotten directly from the Father without any contact of Mother Lakshmiji. Lakshmiji was present just before Narayana, engaged in the service of the Lord. And still, without contact with Lakshmiji, Narayana begot Brahma.
This is all-powerful. Krishna is omnipotent. When we want to beget a child, we require the help of a wife. I cannot beget a child alone. Of course, there are some instances. Generally, it is not possible. But Krishna, Lord Vishnu, produced Brahma without taking the help of his wife, Lakshmi. She was present there. And that is called omnipotency. He is not dependent on anything. That is all powerful. Try to understand. We say God is omnipotent. Here is the instance of omnipotency. That if I want to beget a child, I must marry a wife. But Krishna, Vishnu, even in the presence of wife, without taking her help, he produced Brahma. This is omnipotence.
That is the omnipotency of the Lord. One who foolishly considers Narayana like other living beings should take a lesson from this.
Yes. Therefore, in this Shastra, it is forbidden that don't compare with Narayana. Don't be on equal footing with Narayana. It is not possible. But the rascals, big swamis, they are exclaiming that Daridra Narayana. Narayana has become Daridra. Manufactured word. Where is this word, Daridra Narayana, in the Shastras? But they have manufactured. The Narayana has become Daridra and he has come to my door to beg. Narayana is the master of Lakshmi, Sahasrasata Lakshmi, and he has now become Daridra, poverty-stricken. These foolish things are going on. Therefore, Shastra says, Jastu Narayanam Devam Brahmadi Brahma Rudradi Devati Samatena Viketa Sa Pashandi Bhavidruvam. This rascal says the Narayan, Brahma, Shiva and all other so many demigods, everything is equal. All the same, the level. This is rascalism. Narayana is asamardha. Nobody can be equal or greater than him. Just like Krishna says in the Bhagavad Gita, matta parataram nanyat. There is no more superior thing above me. Neither equal to him. Asama urdha. Asama means no equal and no urdha. Everyone is down. That is the position. Aham sarvasya prabhava matta sarvam pravartate. So these are all foolish theories that with Narayana everyone can be equal. The lack of knowledge, poor fund of knowledge, that is not. Therefore, Shastra has forbidden. Don't do this. don't equalize anyone, even Brahma and Rudra. Brahma, Vishnu, Rudra, Lord Shiva, they are actually sitting on the same platform. Still, Vishnu is the supreme. Nobody should equalize Brahma, Rudra, even. What to speak of others? So if one does so, jastu narayanam devam brahma rudradi daivati samatena vikhata, equalize sa pashandi. This is the meaning of pashandi. Pashandi means non-believer, atheist, demon. That is called pashandi. Go on.
Narayana is not an ordinary living being. He is the personality of Godhead himself, and he has all the potencies of all the senses in all parts of his transcendental body. An ordinary living being begets a child by the intercourse of sex, and he has no other means to beget a child other than the one designed for him.
Yes. Generally take birth from the vagina. But Narayana is all-powerful. He begets a child from the navel. This is all-powerful, omnipotent. Why? Why it is so happening? That is Narayana. Every part of the body has got every potency. That is explained in the Brahma Sangita. Angani jasya sakalendriya vittimanti. Angani, the different parts of the, that is spiritual body. The different parts of the body of Krishna or Narayana has got all the potencies. Just like I can see with my eyes, but Krishna can eat also with his eyes. The foolish rascal people will say that you are offering Krishna foodstuff, but where he has eaten? It is lying there. He has not eaten. He does not know, the rascal, that Krishna by seeing can eat also. Angani jasya sakalendriya vittimanti pashyanti paanti kalen. Just like the washerman who refused to supply cloth in Mathura, Krishna immediately cut his head with his hand. You know this story. How it is possible to cut one's head with the hand? That is called omnipotence. Read. Little more.
But Narayana, being omnipotent, is not bound to any condition of energy. He is complete and independent to do anything and everything by his various
that purposes. Is explained in the beginning of Srimad Bhagavatam. Avijna sarat. Sarat. Sarat means he is not dependent to anyone. He is self-sufficient. Everything. That is God. Nowadays there are so many incarnations of God, but as soon as there is some toothache, immediately, oh, doctor, give me, same. Hello, you are God, you save yourself, welcome to doctor. So these rascals are going on. So it is very difficult to preach Krishna consciousness. The whole world is overburdened by these rascals and demons. So atom bomb is waiting for them. Yes, it will be finished. All the demands will be finished. Thank you very much.